Good day, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Briareos Kerensky, and welcome to the review of Panty Party, a game currently available on PC and Switch. This review will focus on the latter. In Panty Party, you take the role of Eureka, an high school girl turned into a pair of panties by Baka Panty, a sentient pair of panties, to stop Panzi, an evil pair of panties who wants to turn humans into, well, panties. Japan! Although, this game is from Taiwan. Also, yeah, you'll hear the word panty a lot. So, the story is as nonsensical as it can and should be, and the fact it's played straight by every character in it makes it funny and enjoyable. Panty Party digs into typical fetishes of ecchi anime and revels in them, and it will make you laugh in multiple occasions if you like this kind of humor, and chances are that you do if you are interested in a game called Panty Party. Just to make this clear, there is no nudity or even upskirt shots in here, just a bunch of normal and not so normal sentient panties flying around fighting with what have you, from swords, let's say punches, to bazookas and machine guns. The game takes the form of a third-person shooter. You can choose between a total of 17 type of panties, each with its own set of 3 attacks and special abilities. With the exception of Eureka, all panties must be unlocked in story mode by completing 2 secondary objectives, like never dying during a stage or clearing it within a time limit. Panties can jump and hover for a short period of time, as well as enter passion mode to temporarily improve stats and gain access to alternate attacks. Enemies are locked on automatically once they enter active weapon range, but the lock-on doesn't track elevation. If you are not careful, your shots will be blocked by terrain features. This is particularly obvious if you are on the lower side of the dam stage or are firing from the roadside to panties on normal sidewalks. L and R dodge left and right respectively, and you dash by holding down the left stick. Controls work well, although dashing and dodging might prove a bit counterintuitive and not so comfortable. Having a single dodge button and inputting the direction of the dodge is more natural, and holding the stick down to dash isn't the best. Ranged attacks can be avoided by simply strafing in one direction, and once the enemy closes, it's better to start hammering the attack button rather than trying to get away. Combat is nothing to speak about, it's functional for the kind of game Panty Party wants to be. After a close range combo, targets are downed and invincible until they regain their footing, which can be easily exploited by characters with a focus on close range combat like Rin. Story missions won't last longer than 3 minutes, and often story segments are longer than what you play. This is something I'd usually complain about, but once you complete story mode, something that will take a couple of hours, maybe 3 if you want to unlock all panties, all you are left with is local multiplayer and an arcade mode. And story cutscenes quickly become the only incentive to go through the game's dull battles. Truth to be told, Panty Party has a good selection of varied stages with several unique features, but the combat system is so basic that everything is lost once you actually fight. The game looks very basic, to the point of all panties having the same winning animation. The frame rate is solid, but locked at 30 FPS. Illustrations during cutscenes are nice, but their number is extremely limited. Panty Party is available in multiple languages, and something you'll notice immediately if you play in English is that the text hyphenation is absolutely terrible, and text changes size to accommodate new words as it builds up. Sound design mirrors the graphics, with an impressive voice work and stock sound effects, but Panty Party does feature its very own theme song, which I guess it's the highlight of the game?
Yuriko!
Panty Party is a forgettable game with a very limited appeal. It's good for a laugh or two, but nothing more. It has come to my attention that PlayAsia has an exclusive physical edition for pre-order, but I won't be skipping this unboxing. Whatever. I hope you have enjoyed this review and you stick around for more. Briarios Kerensky, over and out.